In this video, I will talk about how to convert a shortest path problem to a transshipment problem, which can be solved using the transportation simplex algorithm. The problem of finding the path with the minimum length from node I to node j in the network is called a shortest path problem. The shortest path problem is equivalent to minimizing the cost of sending one unit from node I to node j, with all other nodes in the network being transshipment points. The cost of sending one unit from one node to another is the length of the arc, if such an arc exists. If there is no arc between these two nodes, we can think of the cost as a large positive number denoted by m. Now let's see an example. This is a directed network. It has 6 nodes and 9 arcs. Suppose we want to find the shortest path from node A to node D. We can think of node A as a supply node and node D as a demand node. All other nodes, B, C, E, and F, are transshipment nodes. Let's formulate the transportation tableau for this transshipment problem. We put node A in the first row and node D in the last column. The supply of node A is 1, the demand of node D is 1. For each transshipment node, we add a row and a column. The supply for each row is 1, and the demand for each column is 1. The cost coefficient is the length of the arc if such an arc exists. For example, from A to B, the cost is 2. From A to F, the cost is 3. The cost coefficient is m if an arc does not exist between these two nodes. For example, from A to C, the cost is m. Because this is a directed network, there is no arc from C to B, so the cost is m. From one node to itself, the cost is 0. For example, from C to C, the cost is 0. This is a balanced transportation problem. We can solve this problem using the transportation simplex method. The optimal solution is shown in the tableau, which corresponds to this path in the network. The z value is 14. Let's see another example. This is an undirected network. Previously, the unit transportation cost from B to F is m, because the flow is only allowed to go from F to B and not B to F. This is an undirected arc, so the flow is allowed to go both ways. So the unit transportation cost is 1. Similarly, from C to B, the cost is changed to 6. From E to C, the cost is changed to 3, and so on. This is a balanced transportation problem. We can solve the problem using the transportation simplex method as well. The optimal solution is shown in the tableau, which corresponds to this path in the network. The z value is 14. Okay, that's how to convert a shortest path problem to a transshipment problem. Thank you for watching.